My name is Blake Wiedeneft. I'm an assistant professor in the Department of Microbiology and Immunology. My lab is really interested in understanding what happens when bacteria get sick. That's not something a lot of people in the general public think a lot about, I think, but it's something that happens a lot. In nature, it happens 10 to the 23 times every second.
The Wiedeneft lab studies CRISPR systems, which are these protein machines that bacteria use to protect themselves against viruses. And so we study that and we try to determine the blueprints of these systems, so really understanding how they come together and function. And to do that, we use structural biology. So most of my projects in Blake's lab have been to try and understand the structures of these machines.
You were studying immune systems in bacteria, and as a consequence of that, of understanding how those immune systems work, now we've been able to borrow parts of the bacterial immune system and put them in human cells in a way that allows us to cure human genetic diseases.
My name is Jennifer Show, and I was a doctor of nursing practice at Montana State. So oral health, as far as nursing, it's never really been fully emphasized. But what we need to start considering is that the oral health does affect our overall systems. So people with type 2 diabetes, particularly if they have uncontrolled glucose, they're more at risk for things like periodontal disease. So there's much more to teeth than just, I have a pretty smile. It does affect nutrition, and it does affect your body systems as well.
For the rural communities in Montana, there really is limited access to health care. And this is especially true on the American Indian reservations.
And if you look at where we're at, we are situated in north central Montana in the middle of basically nowhere. So when I was doing my project, there was actually only one dentist for over 5,000 people. So getting them access is always a challenge.
Students learn about the importance of saliva, the importance of the gums, various pathologies that affect those. So they can go out to the rural communities and have some clinical experience there, which the communities really enjoy. And the students really enjoy because they're gaining some valuable hands-on experience.
My name is Matthew Fields. I'm director for the Center for Biofilm Engineering. Our mission is to promote and conduct biofilm research and to generate new biofilm discoveries and knowledge in an interdisciplinary research and education center.
Biofilms are a huge problem on medical devices and within urinary catheters. The buildup in them can cause catheter-associated urinary tract infection. It affects around 300,000 people annually and costs the healthcare setting around $300 million annually. So in the lab, to address this huge issue, I have been modeling both what happens inside of the catheter and on the outside of the catheter. And these two different models will show the different migration of the biofilm and hopefully give us a better idea of what's happening inside of the body.